Oh, hello. So you want to learn how to build your own guitar pedals, but actually you don't know how to start. You don't know anything about electronics, about soldering and all that stuff. Don't worry. My name is Adrian and I run small guitar pedal business in Poland. And I'm here to share my experience with you and learn you how to build your own guitar pedals. In this video, I will show you how to recognize almost all parts you will find in any guitar pedal, how to read the values, how to recognize them. So yeah, let's go to the workbench. So inside every pedal you will find resistors, capacitors, electrolytic capacitors, transistors, diodes, integrated circuits, potentiometers, and all those parts are mounted on PCB boards. This is the close view on resistors. As you see, they have few stripes in different colors. It's a color code and it tells us exact value of this part. Here you can see color code table. Most resistors you will see will have 4 band code or 5 band code. So here we have brown, black, green and gold. So we need to read 4 band code. Brown it's 1, black it's 0 and green it's 100k multiplier. So this resistor's value it's 1 mega ohm. You can also help yourself with multimeter and check exact value. As you see, it's really close to 1 mega ohm, but it's not really 1 mega ohm. Why? It's because each part has its own tolerance, so real values are a bit different. Now take a look on this resistor with 5 band code. Now I want you to stop this video and check the value of this resistor in our table. After that, leave a comment what's the value of this resistor. Next, we have capacitors. As you see, we have different types of them, but actually all do the same. They look different because they're made of the different materials. But for now, don't worry about this. On those, instead of color code, we have digit code. Here you can see table with digit codes and values. So for example, we need to find 47 picofarad capacitor. It will have 470 code. As you see, some manufacturers just write 47 and it means it's 47 picofarad. The others just use the code. Here we can see 104 code. Don't worry about other digits. So let's check our table. 104 code means it's 100 nanofarads. Some multimeters also allows to check the values of capacitors, but be sure to connect your cables in the right place. Here you can see electrolytic capacitor. It's very important to know those parts have plus and minus, so it means those are polarized. Negative legs are indicated by bands printed on, like this, and also have shorter legs. Next we have diodes. For sure you know LEDs, but LED light emitting diode is just one type of many different diodes. Diodes also has negative and positive legs. We will see dark band on a negative side. Also, usually negative legs are shorter. Here you can see transistors. They have 3 legs and can be in different enclosures. There are a lot of different transistors. Each transistor has its own model number printed on. For example, here we have 2N3904 transistor. It's a BJT type NPN. And it has 3 legs. Emitter, base and collector. On the schematics, emitter is always the leg with that small triangle. But for now, don't worry about this. I just want you to know that we have a lot of different equivalents of each transistors. And it's important that sometimes legs are swapped. That means sometimes emitter will be leg 1 or sometimes leg 3. Also, you need to know that we have NPN and PNP transistors. Each transistor has its own datasheet. It's kind of user manual for each transistor. You can use Google search to find it. Just type transistor model and add datasheet or PDF. So if you're building any circuit, be sure to use correct model of transistor. Next, we have integrated circuits. You will see them in many different packages, for example like those with 8 legs or with 14 legs. Each IC has its own model printed on. And it's also important to place them in right angle. Here you can see small dot and cut in IC. Also, the PCB board has printed image of that IC with indicated cut. Next, we have potentiometers. We use them to change some settings in pedals. You can see printed values on each of them. B on the front means linear and A logarithmic. Values like resistors are in ohms. And finally, we have PCB boards. Those are used to connect all parts together and keep them in place. You can see a lot of different types of boards here. Professionally made, homemade and strip board. Also, we have some mechanical parts in each pedal. For example, switches, jacks, and of course enclosure. Here you can see enclosure I will use in next video. And here you can see my finished pedals. That's all for today. Be sure to check my next video soon. Cheers!